Hello everyone, Adam here. Today another episode of the Do-It-Yourself Electronics, and I will show you today how to build your own Internet of Things device from the scratch. Actually, we'll be using only ATtiny chip or Atmega, whatever you want, and SIM800L. So this is the chip, this is the SIM800L module, and humidity and temperature sensor DHT22. And the concept is that this device here will upload the data from the sensor, from this, using SIM800L with the SIM card here over GPRS to the ThingSpeak platform. So this is the platform that will do some analytics and present the data. I already have one channel created here, but you have to create your own. So let's start with creating the channel first. So you have to be registered here, so the registration is free, and then you go to the channels, my channels, then you can do new channel, name it here, like, I don't know, my IoT one. Description, I'll be showing some temperature measurements and the label. So the DHT22 is capable to do two kind of measurements. One is temperature, so put temperature here, click second channel, second field, sorry, humidity. Then we have to make it public, and let's save it now first. What is important that you need to go after that, it's now empty, but you need to go to the API keys and you need to copy this one. So this is the API key that the device and the chip will be using to upload the data from the sensor. So now let's go to my GitHub page, and the project is named Smart Metering. You have to, the URL is here, you have to download it first. So clone on download, download zip file, it's downloading. You have to pick some directory, whatever. Okay, it's probably here. Let's list the files, then you do the unzip. As you can see, there's plenty of files, but I'm using ATtiny 2313 here, so I will pick the file named main3bc. So we have to first, before we do anything, we have to add the read and execute file, writes to the file that will be used for compilation. These are basically the file compile at TinyP, but if you are using Atmega 328P, you have to select this one. But I will do this one. Oh yeah, I have to go into inside the directory. This is why it's complaining. Okay, now this, and now we have to edit the source file named main3bc or main bc, depending on the chip you are using. I'm using this one. And if you look into the code, there's information that you have to put correct APN name, username, password, PIN value and API key into the code. So now, beginning from the APN definition, you have to put APN access point name that will be used for the GPRS connection. In my case, it is named Internet, and you have to put password and username. In my case, it is empty, I don't have, because my network operator is not requiring this kind of credentials here. and then scroll down, you have to go to this part and you have a HTTP API key. You have to copy the API key that you have created for your own channel. So you copy it from here, API keys on your channel. Let's put it now and save the file. So Ctrl S, save the file. As you can see, it will be uploading the data to the ThinkSpeak.com server with field 1, field 2. These names are corresponding to the names of your channel. So you have field 1 here, field 2 here. If you have more sensors, you'll probably need to enable more of them, and then the same approach is taken to upload another fields. Okay, so let's save it. We can close the text editor now. Let me check if all is fine. So I have internet name here. I don't use user and password. And I don't have PIN code, but if you have one on your SIM card, you need to modify also this field, okay? So let's maybe minimize this window. And yeah, we have downloaded data here. We can now attach the USB ASP programmer. So I will put the chip here to my board. So when I have connected all the wires necessary for in-circuit programming. Now I will connect this to the USB. So you will see how it is being done. I mean the programming. Now I have to launch the compile, the respective compile script, compile ATtinyB. Maybe I will display it first. Ah yeah, one more thing. Attention, if you are using external crystal, and I have one, if you can see here, it is a XL 8 megahertz. So I need to modify the compile ATtiny file. Yeah, let's edit this. ATtinyB. Let's put this value here, which should be 7F. Okay, now I will do the compilation and we'll see if it's uploading. Yeah, it has to be done as a root. So I'm using sudo command. Let's do it once again. So we'll see if there's anything else we should do. Okay, it's saying that it put this 7F value. So the chip will select the XTAL as its clock. Now we have to detach the programmer. Move the chip to the board, so we'll remove it from here. To put it in correct place and orientation. Now I will attach the SIM 800. Notice that I have SIM card here with the APN allowed that was put into the source code. Oh yeah, probably. I have connected here as a power source 3 AA batteries. So it's 4.5 volts, I believe. It's now turned off. And for needs of this presentation, I will also be using USB to serial port adapter just to show you what this chip inside is telling SIM800L to do. So you will have full knowledge how it is working. And I will now connect it to the USB port. Okay, on the PC I will now launch the serial terminal just to show you what it is doing. So sudo putty Let's run it in background. Okay, I have serial console settings, so you can see USB 9600 speed. Let's open, and you now see my device here, and I will switch this one on. Okay, it started to blink. So if the frequency of blinking lowers, that means the device registered to the network, but before it does, first the chip configures the speed of the serial port, writes the configuration to the flash, it checks the pin, it enables the radio, and now it takes 60 seconds for the device to register into the network. It takes 60 seconds because it's written in the code. So if you scroll down to the main function, you will see that right here we have initializing, writing down the config, and then first commands is enable radio and wait 60 seconds. Then we'll check the registration, and then we can configure the access point name, username and password, and write down the config of the APN. So we have to wait a while. These commands will be sent in, I believe, 30 seconds or something. So on my channel you will find the diagram of this device. You have to scroll down here and you can see two diagrams. One is for Atmega. Okay, so it's now configuring the APN. It starts to connect to the GPRS. As you can see, it's blinking fast, so it's now connecting to the GPRS, and it will be uploading the data from this sensor. So it's now reading the sensor, it's initializing HTTP, and now it's uploading the data. Yeah, so this is how it's done, and now it finishes the connection. So within 10 seconds it will disconnect and switch this device to standby modes to preserve the power on the battery. Okay, it's now switching off the radio, and it's putting the device into the sleep mode. Okay, so this data should be already visible on the ThinkSpeak platform. So if you go here to your channels, my channels, we have this second channel. I believe I saved it, but I don't know. And private view. Okay, we have our first measurement. So this is my room, indoor temperature 24.2, and the humidity is 49. So it's almost perfect. Okay, so let's get back to the design. So in my project directory, you can see there are four diagrams. So I do recommend you to using this quartz XTAL clock, because otherwise it will desynchronize with the SIM800 module and you'll be not getting any data, because it will not be able to speak. This one will not be able to speak to this, because the speed on the serial port won't match. Okay, so if looking exactly on this device I have here, I'm not using this solar cell, I'm not using lithium ion battery, I'm using this 3-pack of AA batteries. So the real schematic for this is here. I have some capacitors, but I also have some old pad from other project. This is a 5-volt stabilizer, but I'm not using this pad. As you can see, it is connected right here directly, so this pad is not used anymore. It's simple, this capacitor, the XTAL beneath, and SIM800 and the chip. If you intend to use Atmega, you have to go here and select this file. So the diagram is almost the same, only the pin numbers differ, and that's the only difference. And when we look into the code, when we go back to the to the program code, you can see that now the device has been put, it has been put into the sleep mode, and it waits, actually it waits 120 times of 60 seconds, so it waits 2 hours before next measurement. You have to, if you want this measurement to be more frequent, you have to modify this value. And when this one, when this loop is finished, it will go out of the sleep mode, go to the beginning of this long loop. It will turn the radio back on and then go through the same procedure once again. So now it's sleeping, it uploaded the data, and it will re-upload a next measurement in 2 hours. Okay guys, I believe that's all for today. I don't want to bore you. Look at this page on this project, create your own account here on the ThinkSpeak platform, and you can upload as many sensors as you wish. Thank you very much. I hope you enjoyed the video, and bye bye.